Craniopharyngioma is a benign, slow-growing brain tumor that most often affects children between the ages of 5 to 14, but can affect kids of any age. The tumor can vary in size and shape, with some areas that are solid and some areas that are cystic or filled with fluid. The tumor does not spread to other parts of the body, but is an issue because it grows within the confined space of the skull, pressing on important nearby structures and causing a range of problems. The location of a craniopharyngioma is always within the cellar or suprasellar region of the skull, located right behind the eyes. Suprasellar refers to the space above the cellar area. This region houses important structures of the brain, which become compressed by the tumor depending on the way it grows. The main structure affected is the pituitary gland and stalk, which are integral to hormone production. If the tumor originates near the lower end of the pituitary stalk, it may remain in the cellar region and will press against the pituitary gland and may result in stunted growth, delayed puberty, as well as excessive thirst and urination. If the tumor originates closer to the top of the pituitary stalk, it has a tendency to grow within the suprasellar region of the brain. This can result in compression of the optic chiasm, optic nerves, and hypothalamus. In addition to the symptoms already mentioned, a tumor compressing these structures may result in tunnel vision, loss of visual clarity, weight gain, sleep and memory problems, and fatigue. Craniopharyngiomas can also form or grow up higher into the suprasellar space and cause a blockage in the third ventricle, a cavity in the brain that helps circulate cerebral spinal fluid. This type of blockage may lead to a buildup of fluid within the other ventricles of the brain, causing symptoms of headache, nausea, vomiting, confusion, and drowsiness. In many cases, a tumor that originates near the midpoint of the pituitary stalk will grow into structures of both the cellar and suprasellar regions. The initial treatment for craniopharyngioma depends on the location, consistency, and size of the tumor, but almost always includes surgery. Traditional open surgery is when a piece of the skull is temporarily removed to access the brain. The various entry points for open surgery are shown here. During minimally invasive surgery, an endoscope is inserted through the nose to access and remove the tumor. For more information about craniopharyngioma and the research being conducted, please visit the Children's Hospital Colorado website.